Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more.
Good morning and welcome to the Boomer and the Beard.
I was working
It's not Boomer and the Beard
you
right now.
Not try
There's no beard.
In my way.
This is the beard.
It is Boomer and
the door.
Sandy Lou Who.
Take this job and shove it.
With Connor.
So we need to kind of just, I think we should hold off on having this discussion because I think it'll be so much better if we have this discussion when our fearless leader on National Boss Day, since today is National Boss Day and employees are to honor their bosses. Connor, do you think that'd be a good idea that when our fearless leader, the Beard,
decides to grace us with his presence?
Absolutely. You know, time is really relative, I believe. So by being late, I think we are actually all just very early. And I think that only our glorious leader could skew time in such a way. Really makes you ponder his true greatness.
So normally...
Oh, man.
Usually, Connor, since this is maybe... You will probably have the best digs when our leader does appear here. Since you are hit with your scale of text messages, usually it is a text message, I'm running late or on my way. What would be the scale of measurement of nothing?
So the way I like, okay, so I'm supposed to be here at 4:45. If I text Zach at 4:45, it means I'll be 5 minutes late. If I text him a little after that, it means 10 minutes late. If he doesn't hear from me by like 4:50 or hasn't seen me, that's when you panic. You call me.
Yes, yes.
And then I'll always pick up because I have my phone right next to my bed. So I've never actually been here or been late, you know, like as in coming up after the show starts. So this is a first for I think anybody on the show.
Happy Friday.
I know. This is awesome.
Well, good morning. I know that we'll talk about that here in just a little bit, but with everyone that is out there, good morning to everybody. So how are you doing this morning? We'll just go through and kind of do the round table.
Yes,
here.
I'm doing fantastic this morning. It is Friday, thank goodness. And I'm looking so forward to today's show. Not only because of our fearless leader being fearfully late, but because we've got an awesome visitor coming in today.
Dr. Lang is
coming in.
Wonder if it's like there's a muscle in the back that lets you hear your alarm clock. Can we ask him that
question? We need to ask him that. We definitely need to ask that question because that would be very interesting.
It'd be a good question. Connor, how are you this morning?
I am doing good. You know, I'm just glad that we're up and running, and I was able to figure out Zach's audio. So hopefully, we sound nice and silky smooth over the air.
Are you ready to gloat? I mean, are you ready? This is your shining moment.
This is your moment. Yes.
If there was like the NCAA basketball when they show the highlight reel, you know that one shining moment. Like this is your deal. So you'll be able to come in hot more than any of us.
That's true, but I also want to keep my kidneys.
And his job. Smart. Connor's smart.
Yes, he is. He's very intelligent.
I guess Will Hampson back at the studio. Will, how are you doing this morning?
Doing great. You guys are sounding good. And I was wondering why things sounded good. And now I know.
It's because
Zach's not there yet.
Yes, the studio is minus testosterone.
Yeah.
Which is funny because he doesn't have any.
Oh, he's going to be so angry.
Oh,
is he driving faster now?
Yeah.
Oh, probably, and probably shouting at the top of his lungs.
Exactly. He's going to come
Hey, man, quit talking about me, man. My show.
He's probably done switched it to Rick and Bubba by now.
Yeah. That is fantastic. Zach, we love you.
Yeah, no, this is great. Maybe what's going to happen is this will be the kickoff 15 minutes. He'll just be late every day.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
he's like, I can get used to this.
Need some triumphant entrance music as he walks in.
Yes.
Like,
hey,
he's here.
Yay.
I'll get the Rocky music ready. That can bring us into
there
the next
segment.
There
you go. There you go. Oh, my goodness. That would be fantastic. So how was your day or how are you doing?
My morning was incredible. And I was almost late myself.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because, you know, everybody, you know, I'm kind of telling on myself, but we talked about it, that every morning I get up. I have to have a routine because I'm diabetic and I have to have the food in the system and just I'm a routine guy.
Sure.
So I go to the Waffle House in Athens every single morning at 4 o'clock, which could be scary because people may come want to eat breakfast with me and I will welcome that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Until it goes south.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But this morning I was there and I was about ready to get up and go and there was a gentleman that walked around kind of secretly as his friend was at the jukebox.
Mm-hmm.
All right, which was kind of cool because he put it in the jukebox and played Tennessee whiskey. So I'm like, okay, this guy's coming in kind of strong this morning. And the guy goes, hey, it's my buddy's birthday today. And he was walking person to person. And Friday mornings at the Waffle House in Athens, there's more people than other days.
Uh-huh.
So it's kind of a good little crowd going on there. And he said, my friend's his birthday, but he's feeling really sad today because he got turned down for a major record deal this morning, which I'm like, major record deal? Do they call you at 4 in the morning and go, hey, it's not working out? But I'm there. I'm listening. And he said, if we sing happy birthday to him, he will sing to us, and he is the best singer in the world.
What?
So I was like, because I'm kind of one of these people. The fact that I'm here on this show proves this point. I'm kind of one of these individuals that if there's something intriguing to me, there's that little devil and angel on your shoulder, and you're kind of making that decision of, do you stay? And the devil was saying, be late. This could be your viral video moment where you're going to take this video and you are going to be famous. But I had to, good thing I came in because it would have been the Sandy Show.
There you go.
Which wouldn't have been bad. I mean, we would have been able to do it yourself too. But so it was very interesting. I wanted to stay at the Waffle House in
Athens.
I
wish you would have.
Yeah, because it's those kind of moments I want to stick around for a lot.
Yeah.
It was a good morning. Good night. I'm excited about Friday. I'll be calling a football game tonight in Madison. Another one that's kind of fun with being the voice of James Clements football. So I'm excited about that's kind of been like a bucket list for me. I've done so many things in my radio career at the Havoc and things like that. But as a kid growing up in Kentucky, I always wanted to be like the announcer for the Kentucky Wildcats that was kind of my thing. So I know I'm not going to get that. I've kind of come to grips with that. But I am at the point to where I can call some James Cummings football or a little local football team.
There you go.
Kind of get to be the voice of something. It's kind of cool. So.
And being right there in your own community, that's really cool too.
Yeah, and I'm excited. That. My son Timothy, who is the man child in our house, he's 14 years old. He's 6'1". He's 230. He's a big kid. Eighth grader.
Oh, my goodness.
So he will go on to play football for James Cummings next year. So it was kind of that moment where I've done so many things in my career, but I've really never been able to involve my kids. They've done things where kind of like Zach does with his son saying, my dad's weird,
yes,
that kind of thing. I've not had those moments with my kids.
Right.
Because I've always been, they were younger and, just different times. So to be able to maybe call his name out will be kind of like, that's a cool.
That is cool awesome.
Moment. I'm excited. I'm excited about that. And, we'll see how that goes. But yeah, so it's going to be a Friday. And I'm now Dr. Lang is coming in the 6 o'clock hour.
Yes. I cannot wait.
Yeah. So,
my goodness.
Zach will need all kinds of adjustments this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Zach's twin brother is on the phone. Job security. Okay. Let's go to the phones real quick. Zach's twin brother, Jack.
Oh, hey, y'all there. Can y'all hear me?
I can hear
you.
Yes. Hey, this is Jack, Zach's twin brother.
Okay.
I heard y'all talking all that noise this morning, that first segment, and I'm worried about y'all's job security.
Well, this could be our last day.
Now, just so you know, this is not Zach. This is Jack.
Okay.
This is Jack. I'm okay. Zach's twin brother, but I'm just there. I mean, I know him pretty well.
Oh, I can tell you.
He just like me.
I can tell you're not Zach because Zach would never put a lot of chewing tobacco in his mouth, and I can hear a little bit there.
Never. No, wouldn't never do it, and wouldn't never be late either. But that's neither here nor there. All I'm saying, I'm worried about y'all's job security this morning because I heard Connor say something about, he said he thought Zach was a woman.
I can assure you that those words didn't exit my mouth, but I will tell you this: we are.
Well, I think you said something to the tune of he doesn't have no testosterone, which would make him a woman.
No, I think you'll find that that's actually a real medical problem he has. And Jack, I'm thinking you're really insensitive to these genuine problems faced by the great and glorious host of this show. I think you need to check your health privilege.
I just didn't want you to get canceled for talking that noise about them women. You know what I'm saying?
Jack, I believe you're mistaken, and I think you need to re-examine your worldview.
Okay. All right. Well, I just, look, hey.
I
ain't worried about me now. I'm worried about y'all's jobs, kid. That's all I'm worried about.
Uh-huh. I think,
I hope y'all, I think Zach may be sitting outside the building, so I hope y'all have a good time when he gets there. y'all have a good show. You did a great first segment, and for your last segment on radio, I'm sure it was glorious, okay? Y'all have a good day now.
You too, Zach.
Thank you for the call.
I mean, Jack, yeah. Right. Jack, oh, yeah. Jack. Oh, it was Jack.
Jack.
Jack Wagon.
Jack Wagon. I think we've increased our job security.
Yeah, I know, right? Exactly.
Hey, if nothing else, we're on the air at 5 o'clock this
exactly.
morning.
Exactly.
Better so than we've done most of the week.
We did it. Yes. Oh, my gosh. It's going to be a very interesting show today.
Well, it looks like it is time to take a break. Mm-hmm. I thought we did very well.
I think we did fantastic.
So,
yeah.
Maybe Psychic Jack, his prediction will be right, and... Zach will be here, but this is the Boomer and the Beard Show. Sandy Lou Who, Connor, and maybe Zach Walker. We'll see. Coming up next right here.
70 AM, 92.5 FM, WVNN.
Good morning and welcome back to Boomer and the Beard. Alarm clock will not keep him down. He is Limestone County's only millennial. But he's not really a millennial because he chews dip and hunts. Late, but never late, our fearless leader.
The one and only.
Looks like you gone Cornelius from
okay.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer this morning.
That's fantastic. I love it.
Looking for gold. Zach Walker, good morning.
Yay!
Good morning. Welcome into Hometown RB with Boomer and the Beard. I am the Bearded Wonder, and did something happen this morning?
Hopefully you batted 5 for 5 last night in softball. I would hope.
What a glorious day it is going to be.
Oh, man. It's going to be a day. I don't even know what to say.
Good to meet your brother.
Yeah, your brother is fantastic.
Did you enjoy Jack this morning?
Jack.
I didn't even know I had a twin brother, but I learned something this morning. I learned something this morning.
Jack Wagon, as you said.
There it is. I'm glad you mentioned you wanted to introduce everybody because I was going to just mute everyone and do an entire segment by myself and actually make the radio people think I fired every one of you.
Yeah.
But
the morning is still young. What happened?
I don't know. I can't win.
Okay. Kind of like maybe it's like the not the debate last night, but the political town halls. We were just doing our town hall and he had his own. We just didn't hear. We didn't know where he was at.
Yeah. Right. Well, I could tell you this. No, I can't either. I don't even know what I'm going to tell you.
He's still asleep.
I can tell you that at 5 o'clock this morning, my wife goes, "Oh, my goodness, you're supposed to be at the radio. It's 5 in the morning." And I was like, I'm pretty sure I said, "Shut up."
Oh, no.
And she goes, "I'm serious." And I was like, "Oh, beep." And I rolled over, looked at my phone, and I called Boomer immediately. It's 5 on the dot. I said, "Hey, buddy."
Yeah, how many times did you call him, Boomer?
It was twice. Because here's what we had.
Just twice?
The problem,
really?
The problem that I had.
That's it?
Well, then I called True Help, called Connor.
Well, wait. Hold on. What time was Connor here this morning?
On time.
That's fine.
I just wanted to see if you were calling me, and then you couldn't get me, and you had to call him. Yeah. I figured it would have been after 5:45.
He was whipping in the parking lot about the time that Boomer hung up.
That's fine.
Because I came in
15 minutes after the show started. I can't give you any crap for being here at 5:50 today. Tomorrow's a different ball. Well, tomorrow's Saturday.
Yeah, good luck with that show tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Tomorrow's Saturday. But
we were here early, and then the problem that I had, this is kind of a fear of mine, is that I don't know how to turn any of this stuff on or make it work. So
yeah, but Connor does.
He does.
So
but
as long as he doesn't not show up at the same time I don't show up, we'll be in good shape.
Apparently, you whipped everybody in shape around here about locking doors. because the studio was locked, so we couldn't even get in here.
Well, that's kind of the point.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
What would suck if you're not here?
Yeah.
There's 50 grand in this room. Right. Yeah. Well, no, we're going to lock the door.
Totally understandable. Yeah.
Then you need to get here early.
You have the code. hey, Boomer, I know texting is difficult for you, but the code's in your text message.
No, not that code. Does that code work?
Yes, every single door here.
Okay, well, I didn't know that.
Oh, sweet Maria.
Well, you said you couldn't get into your office the other day.
Yeah,
I mean,
What are you talking about? When did I ever say I couldn't get into my own office?
The other day you said somebody had locked something. Maybe I'm just
kidding. The other day you said, I'm locked out of my own office.
You said that.
No. The office in the back.
Oh, okay.
Because I own this, all of these offices are mine. Okay. And so I wasn't actually talking about my specific office, but one of the other offices that I own as the owner. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Okay. Well, I had
to talk it out here because I was a little confused. I thought maybe I'd done, you know, maybe I didn't.
Well, that day, I mean, I'm not going to lie. That day I was like, when you said that, I thought, well, I just walked by your office and the door was open. I'm like, what is wrong with you?
Yeah, well, we are squared away. Let me tell you. Yeah, so great softball game last night. Obviously, it was so good that I couldn't get up and come to the show this morning. So outside of that, yeah, I mean, everything's working well. Will Hampson, we got his little shot in this morning. So everybody got – I felt like Muhammad Ali with Parkinson's this morning.
Oh,
not that you know, I'm just saying. I mean, you're the greatest boxer to ever live in a debilitated state, you know, where you can't return fire. That's how I felt. That's how I felt this morning.
Welcome to our world.
But I want to be clear about a couple things.
Okay.
You did a fantastic job this morning.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I did it on purpose. Professionals. Here's what you don't know.
Here we go.
Here it is.
I did it on purpose. Because next week when I go to Louisiana, you guys are going to have to cover. And so I just wanted to see what it sounded like. That's why I slept in this morning.
Uh-huh.
Had nothing to do with the fact that
I
accidentally
overslept. That
works out
great for you, doesn't it?
Had nothing to do with the fact that I accidentally overslept.
Nothing at all. Yeah, nothing
at
all.
Why do we have Fox News on both channels?
Just
tired of seeing the other
one. Want to watch real news.
Kind of hard work.
Okay, just to be clear, Fox News is just as bad as CNN,
just the
other way.
But it doesn't give me as much anxiety.
I was about to say, wait a minute. We have the same show on, but they have different content. It's because one's delayed.
Yeah,
I'm real smart. I'm real smart. Real smart.
Yeah, I was good last night because I was, you know, usually go to bed at 7, but I thought let's watch some of these. And I was flipping back and forth. And then I got angry and I was like, you know what? I need to be in bed by 8:30. So I stayed up till it was, you know, most of them were almost over a little bit at 8 or whatever, but the Biden one went a little after that. But yeah, I was.
Oh, I was in the salon last night until after 9 o'clock. And then I had to rush home because we had taxes due by 10:59 p.m. And
wait, what?
Yeah.
11:59.
No, 10:59 because it's Eastern time.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So. Yeah, in the salon until 9:15. I have left the salon in a total utter mess. My girls are going to absolutely love me in a very sarcastic way today. And then rushed home and then did not get in the bed until almost midnight. And I told Boomer this morning when I walked in and Boomer was hanging out in the hallway, I was like, oh my gosh, I almost wimped out on you guys today, but I'm glad I didn't because Zach's not here. We've got total control. I'm just kidding. I didn't
say that.
And
you enjoyed it for 14 minutes.
So wait, there's an alternate universe where all three of y'all didn't show up and it's just me.
That would be great.
That's a good point.
Wow.
I think you're capable.
I think so too.
I hope so.
I think we should plan it, now that you say this.
Yeah.
But not plan it necessarily just to leave Connor by himself.
Connor's like, wait a minute.
Wait. He's like, I'd like to have a say-so in this, please.
But we come out and individuals miss, and then whoever has to do it has to come up with a new name on the fly and do it. We can't prep anything.
That sounds like the last day we ever have a radio show.
I already got it. If it was just me and Connor, it would be Boomer and the Kid. It'd be like a Western.
There you go. Pew, pew.
Hand motions.
I'm trying to be like Zach.
Pew, pew, pew. Yeehaw.
I'm so thankful that you guys didn't have the entire show to yourself.
Oh.
So are the listeners.
Or one day I do a show just as you.
Oh, that'd be hilarious. That'd be real funny. That'd be great. Let's laugh about that, Sandy.
I want to hear.
I'm Zach Walker. I'm going on here. My animal being here, and I'm going to talk about politics.
Oh, my gosh.
That sounds nothing like me. That sounds nothing like me.
Where did that voice come from?
I know. I was like looking at him thinking.
He ate something.
Y'all? Yeah, he did.
He shouldn't have eaten.
Wow.
That's the Waffle House coming out.
Yeah. Wow. Y'all have only known me for a couple. I'm very talented. I just hadn't brought it all out yet. Holding back.
What are you holding out for there, bud?
I gotta feel y'all out and see, you know.
Okay, I just okay.
You felt everything you could feel. All right, it's time to play ball.
Oh my.
Go ahead.
I want to hear Connor go pew pew. Let's hear you do your best gunshot.
Welcome to Boomer and the Kid.
Pew pew.
Yes.
That's my
Connor
best.
Just said my IQ dropped like 10 points right there.
Connor's biggest fear about coming to work here every morning is that he might get dumber. Like, he literally is concerned he might lose his spot at the top of the class by hanging out.
He'll always be smart around me.
Because let me tell you, between the three of us, we weren't anywhere near. You could combine our GPAs and not be the top of the class. Will Hampson, that was a good one this morning, buddy.
Thank you. You know I had to.
Oh, no. If you wouldn't have, I'd have been pissed. Did you enjoy talking to Jack?
Yeah, I mean, I think we should bring him to host one day, too. He was.
Oh, you want Jack to host a... I think Jack could probably make some... I mean, he could probably call in occasionally. I don't know about hosting an entire show. That might be pretty rough, but we could probably...
Find him and bring him in.
Okay. Well, I you know what? I think we might be able to... We'll talk to the... We'll take that little clip. We'll put that clip out. We'll let the fans... if they want to hear more from Jack, I'm sure I could persuade... I mean, look, he's broke as a joke. So, I mean, I could break him off. I mean, he doesn't even need money. I just get him he likes some original chicken sandwiches from Burger King. If I just keep him in an original chicken sandwich from Burger King, he'll come in and talk to us every now and again. So we can keep him on standby.
I think we learned who the cool brother is.
No, there's no question about that. No,
wow.
Jack.
That was open.
He's also jobless and borderline homeless. But yeah, he's incredibly cool. He's been cool since the 70s. He's still stuck there. But
he's got testosterone.
Or 80s, late 80s, rather. Yeah. That may be an off-limit joke for a little while we work through that. Maybe a little more serious in my book here, but you're listening to Hometown Harvey's Boomer and the Beard. We'll be right back.